everyone, it's Tara, Library Nerd VHD. I'm coming at you with a second video because there's a side topic that I wanted to talk about, which is hair loss. So I, as I said previously, I had polycystic ovarian syndrome. I have a thyroid condition. At the start of surgery, I was pre-diabetic and I had sleep apnea. I'm no longer pre-diabetic, and I no longer have sleep apnea, and I don't use my CPAP machine. But because of my polycystic ovarian syndrome, I did lose a lot of hair, and very dramatically, during post-op. And so that was difficult. I was always used to losing part of my hair, but when I was coming off in really big clumps, like you're having chemo, it was very dramatic and kind of was discouraging. So as I explained before, that my wispy hair here at the bottom is kind of how it was throughout my hair on my scalp. It was very wispy and very short and very fine. And up here at the top, you can see growth is starting to come back. And I can't see my scalp as much, which is nice to know. But I feel like there's something that people don't talk about as much in the community, because it really just doesn't happen a lot. But I actually went out and I bought a wig. And I still wear it. I wear it to work. I don't wear it at home. I don't see a point. But I did go to a wig shop. And I hemmed and hawed about it for months on end, because I felt like, I don't know, that I wasn't being real, or that wigs weren't for me. I even looked into like doing extensions or weaves. It was just not realistic for me because I didn't have enough hair to weave into. And I've researched and I found a really good wig shop, so that the prices were actually cheaper to go buy, you know, a wig or two than to get a weave that was only temporary. So with support from those around me, including VHG Redesign Me, we went to a wig shop and we tried on a bunch of wigs, and I wanted to show you my wig. So this is one of my wigs. I bought two wigs. One was $45 and one was $50. This one was $45. She's really short. This is the one I wear in most of my photos now. I love her to pieces. She's really easy. I shampoo her like once a week with a shampoo spray, but you can also like use them like normal hair. You dip it into a sink of cold water and you use soap and you wash her, and then you hang her up and she's fine. Like, I'm talking to her like she's an automatic object, and underneath, I'll show you, this is, it's such bad contrast. Okay, so this is like a netting. You can see better there. In some areas, it's more expansive than others. In the back, it's really gappy. It lets your head breathe a lot. At the top of the scalp, it's like this lacy pattern, just so it doesn't get caught as much. But it lets your scalp breathe, lets things get not so hot underneath, which is really important, because all you want is to wear a wig and actually defeats the purpose of giving your hair a break. Instead, it's not letting it grow. So both of my wigs are kind of that texture underneath. My second wig is longer. I think I've only worn it like once or twice. I bought it for a wedding, but the wedding didn't happen, so I just kind of put it in a bin, and I can't really look at it right now. Yeah, I feel like people don't talk about the wigs as much. I mean, I reached out to a few people in the community to talk about hair loss, and to talk about what they did. And I really only talked to one person who was like openly like, oh yeah, it's okay, I totally got a wig. So I want to be that person for somebody else. I want to tell you, it's okay. If your hair is falling out in clumps and you don't feel like yourself anymore, go to a wig shop and try on a bunch of hair and feel like yourself again. because it's silly that we put a lot of value on our hair, but it does help define us. And if that's what you need to help you give an extra boost to your day, then why the hell not? You're not hurting anyone, you know. Just know at the end of the day, you gotta take it off and you gotta live with the ones underneath. And you still gotta love yourself without the wig. That's very important. But if you need the extra boost during the day, I'm like all for it. I work with teenage boys, and they were actually very concerned about me and said that my hair didn't look good when I was losing it so fast. And they absolutely love my wig. And they know I'm honest about it. I'm not like, this is my hair. I'm like, no, this is a wig. I chose to do something about my hair, and this is what I chose to do. So yeah, that's something I wanted to talk about. So yes, I don't know what else to say. But yeah, wear your wig. And if you guys want like instructional videos on how to wear a wig, I can do that too. I really don't care. I use bobby pins, and I have a hairnet that I use. There's two different types. I have one that's like a, basically like a do-rag underneath. And then I have another one that's kind of more meshy, like the material of my my wig. And depending on how dry my scalp is that day, I'll use whatever one varies. I found that I like the one that's more like the do-rag style, where it's almost like a stocking for your head. I like that one better. It doesn't bother me as much and doesn't slide around as much. While the mesh one on top of the mesh of the wig agitates it a little. So that's something to keep in mind. Also something to keep in mind is pricing of wigs. If you get a synthetic wig, you are looking at a quarter of the price as if you were to get a real human hair wig. Now, real human hair wigs are good, because you can style them any way you want. You can use a curling iron, you can blow dryer, whatever you have. But what's great about synthetic wigs is they kind of come pre-styled, and they are what they are. You can wet them, which I do when I bathe it, I shampoo it, and you let it air dry, and you can manipulate it a little bit when it's wet, but it'll always come back to like this anti-frizzy state, which is nice. And that's why I went with synthetic hair, that, and it's really cheap. So, just consider that. I don't think having the human hair wig is actually worth it, but that's my personal opinion. Alright, that's all I got for tonight. I think I'm gonna go to bed now. Alright, love you guys, talk to you guys later, and thank you to Jennifer Bleacher, who talked to me about wigs. And to fat doesn't define me, who did an educational video way back in the day with her mother, about hair loss and what you can do from a stylist point of view, and how you can treat your hair. So I did appreciate those videos, and I still kind of remember.